Namaste, guys. Good morning. I'll ask you to excuse my just rolled out of bed look. I just let my daughter out of the car for school. And I had no intention of making a video. So this is what it is. This is what it is right now. I'm also going to ask that you excuse, you may see me drinking from this ghetto container. of course, it is not a mug, but I'm using it as a mug. Because I bought this for the master cleanse that some of us are doing in Divine Oneness to put like my soup in and stuff. If, you know, if I decide to use the soup, if I crack, because they let you eat soup if you are like struggling with the, what is it called? This stuff, the lemon water. It's organic lemon juice, organic cayenne pepper, and like distilled or purified water. You know, I use the alkaline water. I just put it in here, and then you're supposed to put organic maple syrup in it too, which just sounds really gross to me, so I don't do that, but that's what I'm drinking. So I just put it in one of these containers so that I could, we started the fast this morning and I wanted to start drinking it, you know, and getting it out of the way. So I'm doing that. All right, in any case, the cayenne got me. Why am I here? I was wrong. Okay, I was wrong about the Super Bowl. But that's not why I'm here. I'm here because I made another mistake, a larger mistake that you guys wouldn't have noticed and that I didn't notice either. That was like pointed out to me, that I was shown, oh, you have to rectify this. So that's what I'm gonna do. First of all, thank you to all of you who are like, oh, Queen, you're never wrong. We've seen you right a million times. Don't worry about it. I appreciate it. I agree, and I appreciate it. And that's part of what I did wrong. How am I going to put this? All right, so that prediction that I gave about the Super Bowl, first of all, I want to, again, own it. I was wrong. So I don't want to sound like I'm making excuses or whatever. But that prediction that I made was like my complete human self. It was not at all my like angelic or divine self. I wasn't using any of my gifts at that moment to make that prediction. And I'll show you how you can tell. So I put the video up, and you can look at the timestamps. I put the video up at close to 9 o'clock. That's when I had recorded it, and I sent it straight from my phone. You can see that none of my stuff that I normally have on there from Movie Maker, my the queenofswords.com that's usually stamped on the bottom, that's not there. None of that's there because I sent it directly from my phone. So I didn't do it until like 9 o'clock. Well, at 9 o'clock, there was only an hour left into the game. So if I was making a real prediction, I not only could have gone and checked the scores before I did it, but I could have and would have checked the energy. What happened was I got overly comfortable. Well, I don't want to say overly comfortable because I want to be comfortable with you guys. But I was making small talk. And the truth of the matter is I did have a vision, you know, sometime in the beginning of last week. First thing, I opened my eyes in the morning and there was these Patriots and stuff. And I still think that there's something, the Patriots, not football players, there was like plantation. That's what I was trying to describe when I told you guys about it. Like plantation and sheep and stuff. And so I put it together, oh, it's showing me something about the Super Bowl and the way that the sheep were being aggressive. I was like, okay, the Rams are going to fight back, and you know, and they're going to win. But that was in that moment. Now, if I had planned to follow up with you guys with a prediction, I would have checked the energy, because that, like I said, that was the beginning of the week. I would have checked the energy of the day. And then, of course, if I was using common sense, again, nothing angelic, I would have checked the scores because the game was over. But if I was doing it legitimately, I would have posted it in advance of the game, like I have in the past. You know, I would have told you in advance with time enough for it to matter and make a difference in your lives, you know, especially were it correct, as it has been on those occasions that I did it in advance of the game or an event or something like that. So The other difference is, or the way you can tell, when I make predictions, even during my readings, like when I see death, I'm never wrong about that. I mean, that's something that I'm both, it's a blessing and a curse. I'm both happy that I'm never wrong about it because I'm able to support people better, having had some sort of insight into it, and having sometimes even them have some expectation that they're going to lose somebody, because they may have somebody that's extremely ill, and I'll say, you know, it's going to be a female, it's going to be like an aunt or cousin or something, and then they'll say, oh yeah, my aunt is real sick, she's real old, and sure enough they'll say, you know, Queen, my aunt did in fact die that night that you did the reading or whatever, and I'm able to talk to people about that and those sort of things. So I'm both happy and, you know, sometimes bothered by the fact that I can do that. And you know, so every other thing that's been right, the past events, the death, the divine masculine, having babies with other women, you know, all that kind of stuff that I've always, or that I am always correct on, completely contrary to this, it was done. I was just talking. I was making small talk, and that was my mistake. Not that you could see me being vulnerable or making a mistake, you know, the fact that I was wrong. That's like of no consequence. The mistake is what I did potentially to people who are watching me, because I have some impressionable viewers who learn from me and to get strength from me, you know, how to read and understand their gifts. They may have a variety of gifts, and they'll say, oh, she has it, obviously, and watch me and get more comfortable with themselves. I mean, this is what's been going on the whole close to 3 years that I've been on, is people telling me, oh, you know, I don't know how I would have gotten through the journey without you. In fact, yesterday, I had three such emails from people, like, thank you so much, your readings are so on point, that, you know, they really, like, guide my life. One woman was really touching. She said that she made up with her mother and siblings a couple weeks ago. I talked about that a couple weeks ago. I said that people would be making amends with their mother, even if they hadn't spoken in years. And with their siblings. And so that came true for her. And she was very, you know, touched by it. And I was very touched that she shared that with me. But I got two other emails similar, you know, about what I had done for people in their lives. And so because people looked to me for that guidance and for the accuracy of the guidance, I shouldn't have just thrown something out there, you know, being playful. Or making small talk is really what I was doing. I shouldn't have. Because also people watch me to, it's my reading style, and for them to, you know, the way that I intuitively read cards and give you meanings that have nothing to do with the card, and it gives them strength that they can do the same thing. Like, oh, you were like one of the first people I saw that you said you saw XYZ coming from the card instead of, you know, what it said. I didn't know it was okay to do that, and now I do. You know, so I don't believe in teaching tarot. I don't believe in teaching spiritual gifts. I don't think that anybody has the right or the vibration to be able to certify another humanoid or human being. I'm a humanoid, I've been clear about that, but a human being even, in something that is of the universe, of God. How are you certifying me in a gift God gave me? Who are you? So I don't believe in these like tarot classes and webinars and whatever, but some of you who've been watching me for a while may remember that I took Doreen Virtue's class, and it was for that reason. I took it because I could, period. She had like these little homework assignments where we had to do a video, we had to do a reading and then like email, type in, you know, words of how the reading went and how we felt and stuff. And I would send her my videos. I did this video today. I did this. This is the reading that I did. So obviously it was making a mockery of the whole thing. But who was she to be teaching people tarot or teaching people to be intuitive, or to have spiritual gifts, or who is anybody that does that? Is how I feel. Okay, that is my personal feeling. So I believe in teaching people the way that I do for free through my public readings. You're free to watch me and watch my style, not to copy me and mimic me without saying this is from Queen of Swords, but to get more comfortable with yourself and with your gifts. So for me to just throw something out and have it be wrong, that could instill fear in other people. You know, like, oh, well, if she's wrong and she's like never wrong, so if she can be still wrong and, you know, on something like this, then like, is it safe for me to use my gifts? And by safe for me to use my gifts, I don't even mean necessarily publicly. Not everybody is meant to be, you know, a tarot reader on YouTube or anywhere else. Not everybody is meant to be, you know, a physical healer laying hands on folks. And it is, people are really entrusting you with basically their soul, with their vibration, when they seek your guidance in that type of way. So certainly not everybody is meant to administer it. But you can use your gifts for yourself in your own life. But people may be afraid to follow them if they're watching somebody like me and I, you know, don't necessarily do what I'm supposed to do, which was to not have made a prediction, you know, in a playful, in a joking way, and in a way that wasn't serious, that wasn't committed to making a prediction. Now, to my, you know, my defense, I did say if they win, as opposed to in the past when I've said when they win, I want my cut. You know, I said if, you know, because, but I did, it wasn't clear enough because it wasn't my, I wasn't consciously doing it. I wasn't consciously saying, hey, this is just something I'm putting out because I saw, I had this vision. And again, what I really should have done was, if I was going to repeat it to anyone else, I should have followed up by following through and checking the energy and seeing if anything had changed or if I still got the same feeling or, you know, all that stuff. So my apologies to those of you who count on me to show you examples of accurate readings and predictions and whatever, tarot, you know, tarot style and stuff, so that you can better yourself. And I pray that I didn't make anybody afraid to use, you know, their gifts, and that if I did, that this, you know, corrects that. All right, I am very, very sorry. Namaste.